And our next topic is microscopic model of current. Here we can take one conductor. Inside of the conductor, this area is known as the cross-sectional area of the conductor A. And there is one battery is connected. The positive terminal is connected to the right-hand side and negative terminal is connected to the left-hand side. And here we can take one small element. And the distance of small element to the cross-sectional area is dx. As usual, we know that there are number of positive and negative ions are there. When electric field is applied to the conductor, immediately the negatively charged ions move towards the positive side. When they are moving, some collision will be there. Therefore, the zigzag motion will be created. Due to this, the drift velocity is created. And the velocity formula, we know that is distance by time. So when we calculate distance, which is equal to velocity into time, here the distance we mention dx and velocity is vd and time, small time, is dt. Therefore dx equal to vd into dt. Now we can consider n is the number of electron per unit volume. Now the volume for the length of dx we have to calculate, which is equal to the area of the cross section into the length of the element, that is dx. Therefore volume v equal to a into dx. But what is dx value? Vd into dt. Therefore volume v equal to a vd dt. Now the total number of electrons equal to volume into n. Therefore the volume is a vd dt into n. Next, total charge equal to number of electrons into charge. Number of electrons A, V, D, D, T into N into E. So, this is known as DQ. And next, current formula I is equal to DQ by DT. DQ value is A, V, D, D, T, N, E divided by DT. So, DT, DT cancel. We can get A, V, D, N, E. Just rearrange it. I is equal to N E A V D. This is known as current value. And next we can calculate the current density. What is known as current density? It is represented by the letter J. J equal to I by A, which is defined as current per unit area of cross section of the conductor. Suppose if A equal to 1, J equal to I. The J value equal to the I value. What is I? N E A V D. So in numerator you can substitute instead of I, N E A V D divided by A. And A cancel, we can get it J equal to N E V D. This formula is valid only when the direction of the current is perpendicular to the area A. Suppose if you take this is the area and current is passing in the perpendicular direction, means for this condition only this formula is valid. But in general, the direction when we are specified, that is in a vector form of current density, J vector equal to NE into VD vector. Therefore, J vector equal to NE, VD value we have to write. As usual, we know already the Newton's second law, F equal to MA and A equal to F by M. Therefore, A is equal to the V by T. So that V means it is VD. And T means it is tau, therefore Vd by tau. And we can calculate the Vd value minus E by M. Therefore Vd equal to minus E tau E capital E divided by M. This Vd value we can substitute here. Therefore J vector equal to minus E tau by M E vector into Ne. When we are grouping, the J vector equal to minus E square tau N by M into electric field E. Therefore, J vector equal to, usually N we have to write very first. So that J vector equal to minus N E square tau divided by M into E vector. And here N E square tau by M, this we write it as a sigma. Sigma is nothing but it is known as conductivity. Therefore, J vector equal to minus sigma E vector. This is known as the microscopic form of Ohm's law. And next, we can write rho. Rho means resistivity. What is known as resistivity? The reciprocal of conductivity is known as resistivity. Therefore, 1 by sigma equal to rho, which is equal to 1 by n e square tau by m. So, m is goes to the numerator. Therefore, rho is equal to m by n e square tau. And now, next topic is Ohm's law. In this Ohm's law, first we can consider one length of the wire. This wire cross-sectional area is A. And the two ends of the wire in between the length is L, small l. And both the sides we have to connect the potential difference. That's battery we have to connect. So this side positive connection and opposite side is negative connection is there. And already we know that the formula for current density J equal to sigma E. And the voltage value V equal to E into L. And E equal to V by L. So this E value we can substitute in that equation J equal to sigma E. Therefore, J equal to sigma into V by L. So from this we have to write J is nothing but it is known as I by A, current density, equal to sigma into V by L. Therefore here we will keep it here and the rest of the content go to opposite side. Therefore IL divided by sigma A equal to V. Therefore the potential difference V equal to L by sigma A into I. This L by sigma A we can consider as a resistance of the conductor, that is represented by the letter capital R. Therefore, V equal to IR, and from this we can write R equal to V by I. But R equal to L by sigma A, so that the resistance R is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. And this resistance is inversely proportional to the area of the conductor. Now the SI unit of resistance is ohm. The symbol is like that. Now we can define what is meant by resistance. The resistance is the ratio of potential difference across the given conductor to the current passing through the conductor. Let us discuss by the graphical method of Ohm's law. First, you can take x-axis and y-axis. In x-axis, we can take volt and y-axis, we can take current. First, we can draw one line which is passed through the origin. So, when the line passed through the origin means according to the mathematical equation, we can write y equal to mx. But here, we can write v equal to ir. Therefore, I is equal to v by r. Therefore, in this equation, we have to write y equal to mx, so I is equal to mv. So from this equation, we can write I is equal to 1 by r into v. This 1 by r is represented as m here, therefore I is equal to m into v. So I is equal to mv means it is look like the Ohm's law. Therefore, the conductor obeys Ohm's law. Therefore, this conductors we call, so it is known as the ohmic conductors. Suppose if you take another graph, in this graph we can take the line which is look like the parabola shape. So that is here the R, that is resistance, is not constant. Therefore, the conductor is not obey Ohm's law. This type of conductors we call so non-ohmic conductor. And next topic is resistivity. The resistance R of any of the conductor is given by R is equal to L by sigma A. Sigma is known as the conductivity of the material, which depends on the type of the material, not its dimension. Therefore, rho equal to 1 by sigma. That is, the reciprocal of conductivity is known as the resistivity. Therefore, the resistance R is equal to rho into L by A. So the resistance of the material, that is R, is directly proportional to the length of the conductor and inversely proportional to the area of the conductor. Therefore, rho resistivity is known as the proportionality constant, or we can say it is known as the resistivity of the material. Now, if we take the R value, that is resistance R equal to rho into L by A formula, we can take here L equal to 1 meter and the area A equal to 1 meter square. Therefore, R equal to rho. Now, we can define the electric resistance of the material as the resistance offered to the current flow by the conductor of unit length having unit area of the cross section. Then SI unit of rho equal to ohm meter. Based on the resistivity of the materials, which is divided into three types: conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Conductors means they have low resistivity, insulators means high resistivity, semiconductors means resistivity value is greater than conductor but less than insulators.